One of my things, and I've been pretty vocal about this in public and in the media, was that the name of the child shouldn't be hidden if, in fact, the child has died while under the protection of the government. And yet I see in this clause that the report must not disclose the name or any identifying information about the child to whom the investigation relates, or a parent or guardian of the child. So exactly the same clause seems to be in there, and I don't understand why. I thought that was going to come out. Because what ends up happening is we end up with mystery children. You know, we're not able to put them in our consciousness as reminders that we should never do this again. You know, we have all kinds of sayings in our society that try and remind us to not forget, or we will remember, never forget this day. We've all got all kinds. Today is remembrance of motor vehicle collision victims. You know, they're there to make us remember these things. So when we can't name a child, we lose them. They're nameless, and they disappear into the system. And soon, even the circumstances around their death disappear. So, and as horrible as this is, but referring to them as, well, you know, the hanging or the suicide, they become a the something, and then eventually nothing, because we can't distinguish this the suicide from that suicide. So we refer to them as the manner of their death rather than by a name. So I'm quite distressed that seems to be the case. But you know what? Sometimes I read this legislation wrong. So perhaps I am wrong, and I'm sure the minister will correct me if that's the case.